remember always being on a search, a constant lookout for the moment when my feelings aligned to fit the perfect position. It came and went, but so did I. My eyes were in the skies, looking for something new. But my heart was in the basement, feeling a little blue. Blasting the groovy music as I ride down the street. Feel like $1 million a comer's counting for me. Breeze in the air blowing so emotionally. Leaf in the wind floating, I got no stability. What you got for me? Cause that's what this about. All I ever wanted was for you to hear me out. Feelings are my best friends, I don't care what you say now. My feelings telling me to leave, so in that case, man, I'm out.
Without you understand the mentality of a people in a culture, you can't communicate properly with this culture. And another thing that's important, when this mentality get a place and become a part of the culture, you start to receive this influence, and sometimes you're thinking and act under influence that you personally don't agree. The center of the decisions, what is true, what is absolute, it's what I think, what I feel, what I decide it is. So the center of reference become us, the man.
I learned my lesson when I realized I was digging my own grave. Some people aren't as blessed. I was the ruler. I was lord over my life. I followed the desires of my own heart, and they took me into a winding tunnel. I had some glimpses of the sun, but I preferred to make my own way. My way was more rainy, but I liked the rain. I liked the storm. World War I. I've never fought in a war, or actually been close to one in any real way, but I'm sure if I was, that I would start questioning life as well. Although traditional values and truth were being questioned well before this time, this era in particular would host a new generation of thinkers that would change everything. Guys like Friedrich Nietzsche, Charles Darwin, Karl Marx, Sigmund Freud. These men had started their careers well before the war, but their ideas and philosophies were now starting to take place in Europe, eventually moving into America.
It's important to we understand that it is not something that's happened, okay, let's create this. No, this is a process. It starts with Immanuel Kant and Hegel, Soren Kierkegaard.
Why the heck does it matter if we know who these old dead dudes are? Well, because whether you know it or not, these men have influenced the way you think and live. What these men did was totally redefine these four concepts of life: origin, meaning, morality, destiny. They said that we are products of nothing plus time plus chance, moving in the direction of nowhere. Moving forward a generation, it was Jean-Paul Sartre that said, "Everything is born without reason and dies by chance." Just so hopeful, right? He was right when he said that we have figured everything out except how to live. Many began to claim that science could explain everything, but nothing could be further from the truth. Put these mentalities together with the oncoming wars, and you are left with whole generations fighting for answers, but no one to give any to them. No guideline or reference. Those had been taken away.
The society, the people is living with a new reference or limits of ethics and moral. When you don't have any reference, as I said, you're not be accountable for anyone. You can live in the society morally the way that you feel that you need. Why be faithful in a marriage? Why not enjoy my life sexually with several people? Despite of the consequence, emotional consequence.
Fast forward some decades, we find ourselves in a culture driven by the word self. When we go looking for answers, we turn inward and rely on our own definitions. What seems right to us is the way to go. We are driven by emotion. We are led by feeling. My friends, really think about what is happening today in popular culture, in music, in entertainment. I am seeing whole generations being raised up with no meaning. Nothing to look to that says this is what it's all about. I too was once led by feelings. I once knew no meaning. I was headed for destruction. It was when I was willing to obey and heed the words of Christ when he said, "I am life." Then I found him. In fact, he found me. Please turn away from being your own guide and place exclusive dependence on the cross of Christ for forgiveness, for life, for meaning, for definitions, for guidance. He can lead your feelings to where they ought to go. He can lead your feelings to where they can be fully satisfied. God bless you in Jesus' name.